Is it about time you had a checkup on your 401k account? ICI Senior Director of Retirement Investor Research, Sarah Holden, shares some pointers on making sure that you're getting the most of your retirement savings plan.
So first thing is to check if your employer offers a 401k and make sure that you're enrolled, because you can't participate if you are not in the plan. Once you're enrolled, a really key thing is to check your contribution amounts, because 9 out of 10 participants are in a plan that has employer contributions. And what this means is that the employer actually puts money into your account. So you want to be sure you take advantage of that, because often it's the case that the amount the employer puts in is going to depend on how much you put in. So it's usually a match. So if you don't max out that employer match, you have literally left money on the table.
You're missing out on a benefit.
You are. This is part of your compensation. It's part of what they offered you when they hired you. You want to be sure to take advantage of it.
So Sarah, it's also really important to keep re-looking at that contribution as you go through your career, because when you hit 50, you're going to be eligible for a catch-up contribution. And really throughout the course of your work life, there could be other adjustments you want to make.
Yeah, so once you turn 50, you can make a catch-up contribution, which means at a time in your life when you have sort of gotten past the saving for education and the saving for a home or a family, you can really focus on retirement, you're able to actually put more money in.
So that's something people should look at if they've reached that age and they might want to boost their savings further.
The other thing to check is if you enrolled at a young age and you haven't revisited your contribution rate, most people increase their contributions over time. So you might want to check that maybe you just need to up it because you started so long ago and you haven't really looked at it recently.
So let's also think about other advice you need to offer people. What about their investment allocations?
So a key change that's happened in plans over time is we really have a whole lot of new options available to folks. On average, there's more than 20 choices in a 401k plan. And some people say, that's great, 20 choices. There's domestic equity and foreign equity and bonds and balanced funds. I'm going to pick and choose and I'm going to manage that. And then there's some other people who say, you know what? I'm really busy, or this seems complicated, I'm going to just have an investment professional take care of it. And there's typically a target date fund. And with a target date fund, you simply figure out when you expect to retire, and then you choose the fund that corresponds to that year, and that fund will be diversified right now for you. And if you're young, it'll be more into equity. And then as you get older, and as the fund approaches and passes the target date, it will rebalance to become more focused on income as you go into retirement.
Sarah, when you give people a last kind of key piece of advice about a 401k, what is it?
So really a key thing is as you go through your career, you may be changing jobs, and especially that first job, that 401k balance isn't going to look that big to you when you go to change jobs, but it's going to compound over the rest of your career. So it's really important to try to preserve those balances. So either leave it behind in your jobs plan, or if you can, move it to the new job, or set up an IRA, and there you could consolidate a bunch of accounts together, and that way you can keep track of them as you change jobs over your career, but also they'll get to continue compounding in that special tax advantage space.
Once you've put that money away, make sure you keep holding on to it as you move on throughout your career.
Try to keep it. It's a special bucket earmarked for retirement, and keep it that way. You'll have a nice nest egg when you get there.